Now, you are out to get modern contraceptives to another 120 million women around the world by year 2020. I mean, this is huge. Mm. How do you plan to do it?
Well, it's really about countries coming up with plans. Now that we have this $2.6 billion in resource from donor nations, the countries build plans from the bottom up, and then we make sure that they're resourced appropriately.
You're up against a lot. There are conservative groups, religious groups in Africa, parts of Asia, and the United States, very vocal against birth control. There are also policies like forced sterilization in India. So how do you plan to counter that negative influence?
Well, what we have to do is put the women and the girl at the center of this. Where family planning got in trouble in the past was that they had these central programs from the top where they were trying to achieve something in population, and they forgot about the woman, that these are about giving her options, educating her, and letting her make a voluntary choice. If you do that, fantastic things happen for her and her family, for the community at large, country, and then globally.
And is that message getting across? I listened to your speech earlier today, and I could tell that you're trying to reframe the issue. It's not about access to contraception. It's not about access to birth control, but access to a better life for women and girls. Is that message getting across?
Absolutely. And the reason that we know that's the right message is that's what women tell us all over the world. I mean, I've traveled now for over a decade, and whenever I would go in to talk to women about vaccines, they would bring the conversation around to, well, what about this shot I used to get, which is Depo-Provera, which is a lot of what women use around the world. And they would say, when they would talk to me about contraceptives, they're talking about it because of the next generation. They're saying, I want to feed the children I have. I want to educate the children I have, but I can only do that if I can limit how many I have or space them.
A personal question about faith. You are a Catholic, and we know the church's stance on contraception. So how do you reconcile your faith and your work?
Well, the Catholic Church has an amazing history of social justice, and they really believe in helping the vulnerable, helping women, helping children. And so I bridge that gap. I grew up in the Catholic faith. I'm still Catholic. I love that social justice mission. And those are the women that I meet out on the ground. So, but what I know that women also need is a modern tool. We need to educate them and let them make that decision. So I bridge the two by saying this is helping women survive, and it's helping babies survive.